What's up, VC? Hey, I'm just going to do a quick contest video here. Turn that shit. I have told you once, I told you 20 times, turn that. Anyway, it's a contest video. The channel is Vinylizer. Fella's name is John. Started a thread. It's a thread, not a contest, sorry. The thread is fingers and pies. Now don't go getting all dirty minded out there. We're talking about, you know how you like have a bunch of things going on at once? You're doing a lot of projects, got your fingers in a lot of pies. Got me? There you go. Anyway, that's the thread, is to come up with an artist or instrumentalist, whatever, a musician that has they've been involved in several different projects. And I've actually mentioned this fella before, so this might be a little repetitive for me anyway, but yeah, I decided to come up with somebody that I know that's been involved in quite a lot of projects through the years, and I'm just keeping my fingers crossed that nobody else is used him yet, but he's pretty common, so we'll see. Anyway, John, I love your channel, dude. I love, like, you show a lot of metal and stuff, and I'm always into that scene. Love a lot of, like, 80s hard rock and metal, and just, I'm way into that, so digging your stuff. What we're rocking to here is just going to be a kind of a segue into the fella that I'm going to talk about. This is Dio Intermission. The drummer on this particular album is one Vinny Appice. That's Vinny right there. He is the drummer for Dio, and I think he was also in the Heaven and Hell project that was Black Sabbath with Tony Iommi and the guys from Black Sabbath, minus Bill Ward and Ozzy. It was Dio's Black Sabbath, sorry. And he played in that project as well. So yeah, that's we could do a whole thing on Vinny Appice, but I'm concentrating on his brother Carmine Appice. Carmine, through the years, has been involved in several projects, so, just a little bit more here. It's loud, I know. Carmine is an American drummer. He is a classically trained drummer. He is known for being in, groups such as, Vanilla Fudge, Cactus, Rod Stewart, Beck Bogert, Appice, King Cobra, Blue Murder. He was influenced by jazz drummer Buddy Rich and Gene Kupra. He has influenced several great drummers, mention him as their influence, including Nico McBrain from Iron Maiden, Tommy Lee from Motley Crue, Roger Taylor from Queen, Neil Peart from Rush, John Bonham from Zeppelin, Eric Carr from, or Eric Singer from Kiss. Eric Carr probably did too, who knows. But anyway, yeah, he's been inducted to the Modern Drummer Hall of Fame as well as the Classic Drummer Hall of Fame. So his credentials are there, you know what I'm saying? Carmine Appice is the shiz. Anyway, I looked through my, I was pretty confident that I had a few albums that represent Carmine's catalog of work. So I'm gonna start going back to Vanilla Fudge. This is actually I've shown this before. This is actually one of the first psychedelic albums I have ever had, but yeah, there's a picture of a very young Carmine Appice right there. Get a good look at King Carmine. Yeah, this is a great record too, if you don't already have it. They come about a dime a dozen around my area, so I know of at least two or three kind of beat, even more beat up copies than the one I'm holding at this store in town here. But yeah, this is Has You Keep Me Hanging On. That's a great song. Also, and this is something that I learned that I didn't know that he was involved with this project, but he played on a track on this Kiss solo album, Paul Stanley's solo effort. He played on the track called Take Me Away Together as One. I don't have a picture of him on this record. This record has seen better days, but you know, I got it for pretty cheap. The vinyl sounds good, so. And then, this is cool. I hope this is the thumbnail they use. Right here. Anyway, that's Paul Stanley with featuring Carmine Appice on the track on there. For a long time, and on a couple, two or three different albums, Carmine worked with one Rod Stewart as well. He played on this Footloose and Fancy Free album. And if you, actually, there's a track on here called Hot Legs. Everybody knows that track. If you go back, like, on YouTube, look up the video for Hot Legs, you'll see Carmine on that video. You can't miss him. He's very Italian, has a dark black hair, dark black mustache, so you can't miss him. But yeah, he played on this record as well, and a couple of other Rod Stewart efforts. I actually had the pleasure of seeing Carmine Appice with this group here back in the 80s. This is a group called King Cobra with their record Ready to Strike. Definitely your typical 80s hair. So Carmine was in every era. He dipped in everything. So, but this is that's King Carmine right there. Actually, on his bass drum, it actually said King Carmine. And yeah, he looks pretty cool there. He fits right in with these guys. So yeah, that's definitely, he was into the metal thing there. And also there's a picture here of Carmine that's pretty cool as well. Notice all the guys, besides Carmine in the band, had bleach blonde hair, while Carmine had the dark hair. Still very cool. I'm not sure, but I think one of these guys is now, has transed over to a female. I can't remember if it was maybe this guy. I can't remember, but anyway, doesn't matter. Just a bit of trivia. But anyway, that's King Cobra, who I got to see open for Kiss. Post-makeup, by the way, it was on their, I think it was on their, which tour was that? Gosh, I always go blank whenever I start doing these videos. Asylum, I think, with Love, Tears Are Fallen, that album. Probably his most recent effort that I'm aware of. I mean, he's probably been involved in several things. But, and this is an album I recently showed briefly for the Rainbow video that I did for B-Sides record. By the way, that thread's going, that contest is still going on if you want to get in that. But a band called Blue Murder, also probably considered 80s hard rock. This is a great record, by the way. And there's Carmine right there. You cannot miss Carmine with his dark black curls, and he always sports the black mustache. But yeah, and there's John Sykes right there, of Whitesnake fame, and also played in Thin Lizzy as well. So yeah, some very talented fellas on this record. So yeah, all right, so that's five projects that King Carmine Appice was involved in. So I actually had a Beck album that he played on too. I just couldn't find it. So there you go. But yeah, that's my entry into the thread, John. If you're not subscribed to the Vinylizer channel, you can't miss it. He's got this cool logo. It's like so killer. It says Vinylizer, and it's like in these big red letters, and it's kind of like heavy metal font, and it's like Vinylizer. I love it. I think I just pulled something. I think it's time to go. This is Brian, aka Cosmic Vinyl. Pet my little puppy. Here, you guys want to see my puppy? And my puppy Coco. And my Coco. Anyway, Cosmic Vinyl signing out. Have a great day. Have a great night. And God bless you all. And blah, blah, blah. See you later. Bye.